I did, Mark, and he tells me that it is remarkable that with over a dozen law enforcement officers out there on I-95, their rifles out, fingers on the triggers, no one got shot. And they were able to take these suspected armored car robbers who wanted to get away with $4 million. They put them safely behind bars.
You see in the video, actually, we have cars in front, cars in the back, vehicles on the side, and we just slowly tighten the noose, stop the vehicle, and get them out. Nobody got hurt.
Sheriff William Snyder says they were ready for action when they, the FBI, and several other police agencies surrounded this car on I-95. Inside, three suspects the FBI alleges were planning a violent robbery of a Loomis armored truck at a PNC bank on Gatlin Boulevard in Port St. Lucie. One suspect describing the murderous plot as like taking candy from a baby, if you have the blank to do it.
We had a helicopter in the air. We had our stop sticks ready to deploy. If the vehicle fled, we had our armored vehicle out there. Our SWAT team was out there.
The FBI was tracking the suspects, Daryl Dudu Kennedy, Alger Lee Ellison, and Martavius Leon Williams, last month in West Palm Beach, when the suspects realized they were being tailed and jumped out of their vehicle, sparking a manhunt in the lockdown of Kaiser University. The affidavit says Kennedy says he was planning the heist for 2 years. Kennedy explained that the driver of the armored truck is going to get shot, making a gun gesture with his hand.
And then, which was really scary, they had planned to execute the drivers. So we really had a very, very aggressive, violent robbery crew moving through Martin County, then coming back, and then ending their escapade right here.
And the FBI affidavit, which I read, says that they were planning on a second armed car robbery as soon as they finished the first. The FBI was working with a confidential informant to bring these suspects to justice. Live in Martin County, I'm Terry Parker, WPBF 25 News.